In this segment, we're going to take the example which we just solved by using forward elimination. We're going to do the naive Gauss elimination and show the back substitution steps. And again, keep in mind that in this example, we are using 5 significant digits. With chopping, which means that all calculations which you are doing, intermediate as well as final, they all have to be with 5 significant digits with chopping. So this is what we obtain at the end of the forward elimination steps by using 5 significant digits with chopping as our answer. We got 20, 15, 10, 0, 0.001, 8.5, 0, 0, 2, 3, 3, 7, 5. So that's what we obtained as the quotient matrix, which of course is a upper triangular matrix. We got x1, x2, x3 as our unknowns. The inside vector which we obtained was 45, 8.5, 0, 1, and 2, 3, 3, 7, 4. So now we need to find out what x1, x2, x3 is by using the back substitution step. So we're going to start from the last equation because that's what we do. And I'm going to show you all the intermediate steps because that's what we need to be careful about in order to be able to illustrate the issue of round-off error with naive Gaussian method. So the last equation I did is 2, 3, 3, 7, 5, x of 3 is equal to 2, 3, 3, 7, 4, as is the case right here. So x of 3 turns out to be 2, 3, 3, 7, 4 divided by 2, 3, 3, 7, 5. So that's the numerator divided by denominator. And that value up to 5 significant digits with chopping is 0.9995. That's what I get. So that's what we get for x of 3. So now let's go and take this number and find out what x of 2 we get. So the second last equation which we have is 0.001 x of 2 plus 8.5 x of 3 is equal to 8.501. So when I'm going to write down this equation the way it's algorithmically solved by using a back substitution, it will be like this: 8.501 minus 8.5 x of 3 divided by 0.001. So we got 8.501 minus 8.5 x of 3 is 0.99995 divided by 0.001. So the value which I get here is 8.501 minus 8.5 times this quantity is 8.4995. Again, we are doing this multiplication. We have to show each intermediate calculation separately. So we're taking this number, multiplying this number, and this is the number which we'll get up to 5 significant digits with chopping. And then divided by 0.001. Now I subtract these two numbers. And what do I get from there? It's 0.0015 divided by 0.001. Now I do the division, and I get 1.5. So that's the value of x2, which I get from there. Now let's go and see what do we get for x1. The x1 will be calculated from the first equation or the third last equation as we're going backwards. 20x1 plus 15x2 plus 10x3 is equal to 45. That's the equation which I have. So that means that x1 can be calculated at 45 minus 15x2 minus 10x3 divided by 20. So minus 15, what is x2? X2 I just obtained is 1.5, and X3 is 0.9999495, divided by 20. Now again, each of these calculations has to be done separately. We cannot do them all of them at the same time, like put them in the calculator and write down the final answer. That's not correct, because your calculator is taking more significant digits than what we are allowed to use here, which is 5 with chopping. So from here, this calculation, I get 22.5, and from here I get 9.9995 divided by 20. Again, I don't do all these subtraction at the same time. I'll first do this and this. I get 22.5 minus 9.995 9995 divided by 20. Now I do this calculation and I get 12.5 divided by 20, and that gives me 0.625. Okay. So that's, again, this is 12.5 up to 5 significant digits, so I get 12.500 divided by 20, get 0.625. So the answer which I'm getting for the Gaussian elimination and using 5 significant digits with chopping for this one, I get x1, x2, x3. X1 is turning out to be 0.625. X2 is turning out to be 1.5. And x3 is turning out to be 0.9995. So this is with 5 significant digits with chopping. Now, if you are going to do the same problem by using 6 significant digits with chopping, you'll get a different answer. And that's the whole point of doing this exercise, was to show you that that Gaussian method has a problem with round off errors. So if you use 6 significant digits, you would get 0.9625, 1.05, and 0.999995. And this is the answer which you get with 6 significant digits with chopping. So you do have a big difference between what you get with 6 significant digits with chopping and 5 significant digits with chopping. Just look at the numbers for x of 2, 1.05 here, 1.5 here. X of 1, 0.9625 here, 0.625 here. Now somebody may say, hey, which one do you know is better than the other one? You can clearly see that which one is better, because I'm going to give you the exact solution. The exact solution for this problem is 111. So that is the exact solution. So you can very well see that by using less significant digits, you are able to illustrate how the Gaussian method is giving you results which are quite far away from the exact result. Now somebody might say, hey, does the Gaussian elimination partial pivoting, which we'll take in a separate example, does that give better results? Yes, it does give better results, and we'll see that in a separate example. And this is the end of this segment.